Have you ever considered that your life has been like a PhD program preparing you for the message that you're here to give? Because you've been through things in your life that you never really should have had to go through. My belief is that you went through them so that you can now turn back and help others navigate that same journey. In fact, your story is your best marketing tool. Content tells, but stories are what sell. In a world where there's billions of websites out there, the way to stand out is to bring your authenticity to the table, right? Because honesty is what sells. As a little girl, I grew up in Iowa, and I was really painfully bullied by other girls. In fact, as a teenager, I'll never forget walking down the hallway one day, I heard footsteps behind me. It was Dana and Liz and Jenny. These girls were mean and they were on a mission to like totally ruin my life. I remember one of them grabbed me and shoved me into a locker. I'll never forget that feeling of being trapped in that locker. I realized in that moment that I was so much bigger than that little part of me that was all bound up inside that small space. And I'm curious, what part of you has been trapped, not speaking up, not letting yourself out? It was that very experience that gave me a knowingness of what it feels like to be not powerful and small and like kicked out of the club. And because I knew that landscape, I also knew what it feels like to be empowered and loved and to belong when I finally found a group of women who truly included me and encouraged me. And so I now have the ability to stand on stage and create an environment where hundreds or even thousands of people in a room can feel a sense of inclusivity and belonging. And so what is that territory that you've explored? What is that darkness that you've looked in the face and that's given you superpowers? Just like I have a superpower to help empower women to rock their businesses. What's your superpower? So do me a favor and post below. What have you been through in your life that's made you who you are? Because we're not peddling a factory full of widgets here, you know? We're actually reaching into our hearts and excavating what's near and dear to our souls and bringing it out into the world to transform the world. And so as you're willing to get vulnerable with the world, to be human, that's what's going to earn the trust and the love of your clients and your customers. And as you're considering what story to tell, because many of you have been through challenges, like quite a few challenges, and you could talk about many of them, I'm going to invite you to choose a story that mirrors what your clients have been through. So for example, my client Susan Pierce Thompson has an incredible global company called Brightline Eating, and she helps people lose weight naturally and keep the weight off. She's got one of the leading edge systems, like one of the best systems on the planet for losing weight. Susan herself has struggled with severe addictions to drugs and to food. She's, as a young person, she's swung back and forth between a size 4 and a size 14. And she knows the journey of binging and then having to come back to her center and what it really means to walk through that journey of weight loss. That personal experience has given her so much cred and credibility, right, in terms of really helping her clients. And so Susan's journey completely mirrors her client's journey. Now, you might have been through something that your clients haven't been through exactly. You can still choose that story to tell. Okay, it doesn't matter so much what story you choose. It just matters that you tie that story back to your client's experience. So for instance, I commonly talk about my divorce on stage, my painful divorce. I went through a horrible separation and then an end of a marriage about 10 years ago. I don't help women navigate divorce, right? But because my whole life was like shattered, my entire personal life devastated, like all of my dreams, the whole vision for what I was going to achieve in my sort of dream life came crashing down on me. I had to rebuild like something from nothing. And that in and of itself speaks to women who are starting businesses, because we oftentimes go through personal transformation as we're starting a business. I'm curious if that's true for you. Have you been through any level of like personal devastation as you're getting your business off the ground? You're like, what, universe? I'm saying yes. And then like personal circumstances are crumbling. That's because we're laying a new foundation for who you're becoming, right? We actually have to start with a new foundation, just like I had to start with a new foundation after my marriage. And I don't help women through divorce. I help women launch businesses, but my story mirrors the transformation that many of my clients are going through, whether it's a divorce or loss of a loved one or loss of a job, right? When our life crumbles and we have to start over, that in and of itself is a teaching and an inspiration that women can pick up where they left off, change careers in midlife, right? Lose their job and start a business, walk away from a career that's just absolutely sucking their soul, and be willing to get out there. And so what have you been through that you know has carved out that wisdom in your soul that your clients are seeking to create in their world? And when you stand for that with a commitment and a power, your customers and clients are not going to be able to ignore you, right? Can you feel this? It's not about convincing anybody to do anything. It's about standing for a transformation. And when you believe your clients and customers can have that transformation in the way that you've had it, you won't ever have to do any more hard sales ever again in your career. And your business, the business that's waiting for you, the clients that are waiting for you, they need you to stand up tall and be willing to tell that story. You know, the world needs you. Life is short. It happens fast, right? And we're living in a time where your message is needed. There is so much pain and sadness and ambivalence and mediocrity and complacency out there. You've been through something that people are literally waiting for. So don't keep it tucked inside of you. Get out there and give that gift today, no matter how perfect or imperfect you think it is. Take a few minutes after this video and do some journaling. What in my life has made me vulnerable? What superpower have I developed as a result of this journey? And what makes me credible? What have I gone through that now makes me credible and committed to my future clients? I'd love to hear the answers. Keep posting below. Keep liking these videos. I love bringing them to you. And thank you for being the very best part of Women Rocking Business. And remember, your clients are waiting for you. They're not just waiting for somebody like you or similar to you. You've been through things that you can help people with that nobody else can help people with because of the way you've been through them. Your clients are waiting for you. They're not just waiting for someone like you, they're actually waiting for you. Mwah.